Hello, everyone, and good afternoon from Bailey Memorial Stadium here in Clinton, South Carolina. We are proud to be bringing you coverage of college football here on ESPN Plus on the Big South Network. I'm Chris Daske alongside John Ork. John, great to have football back, partner.
Oh, man, I couldn't wait. I mean, when the NCAA basketball tournament's over, it's football season to me. I follow all the summer workouts and all the stuff with the Blue Hose.
Of course, the Blue Hose season got moved back a little bit due to Hurricane Dorian last weekend. Of course, they were scheduled to go to Stetson. That game got canceled and had a makeup game here with the Mercer Bears here this afternoon. This will be a good test for this Blue Hose team in this opener here at Bailey Memorial.
Well, if they can pull this one off, it'll be a big win for them. That, you know, Big South has always been kind of the little brother to the SoCon, and SoCon's been around a lot longer. Big South was just established, you know, like 20, 25 years ago, and they're always trying to knock off one of these guys.
Absolutely, and I'm looking forward to, and I know you are too, John, looking forward to getting familiar with a lot of these new faces for the Blue Hose this year. Of course, led by their quarterback, Brandon Thompson, redshirt sophomore. A lot of curiosity here this afternoon.
Oh, yeah, we got our freshman class last year was 67, this year was 66. We're replacing the whole team over the last couple of years.
Blue Hose getting ready to come out and take the field here in front of their home crowd, and the Mercer Bears already on the sideline ready to rock and roll as they try to move to 2-0 on the season here as we get set for the opening kickoff. And we'll talk about the starters for both teams here as the game gets ready to kick off here on ESPN Plus at Bailey Memorial Stadium at Crocker Field. Today's opening kick just minutes away. Listen to just 5'8", but 233. He's a bowling ball. Riddle up the near side, and that one's going to be caught in the end zone for a touchdown, but let's see what the flag is all about. In the end zone, Robert Riddle with a wheel route and able to connect with his running back out of the backfield. Well, let's see what the flag is down at the goal line. Both teams standing around to see what that flag is all about.
Looks like the Blue Hose get the penalty. Mercer's clapping.
We'll take another look at what happened there on that wheel route as they were able to connect play action, and Devison just went out. And a beautiful ball thrown from Riddle to his halfback. And that's going to be a touchdown throw.
Yeah, he just lobbed up there and said, go get it. I'm going to put it where you can catch it and the defender can't. That was a great pass.
Second down here. And short for Mercer. And here's a quarterback keeper. A big seam down the middle again. Second time that's happened. And this time it results in a touchdown run for the redshirt sophomore quarterback Robert Riddle. And that makes it 13-0 Mercer.
I'm not sure that was actually a call there. I'm thinking that was the quarterback did that on his own. Every time he sees that defense.
It was just a good read play right there.
Yeah.
Faked, put it in the belly of his running back, yeah. Pulled it out, and the linebackers bit on it, so the defensive ends, and it's a touchdown for the Bears to go up two scores early on in this matchup. Oh, for Robert Riddle in that offense, first down and 10. PC down a couple of scores.
I might run at least one blitzer right here and have man coverage on the outside.
Here's
there
Riddle
he goes.
Out of the back of his own end zone, going deep down the field. Wide open right receiver is going to be caught at the 40. Look out. He's at the 30, 20, 15, 10, 5. It's going to be a 99-yard touchdown reception here for the Mercer Bears. And that is number 15 on the reception. And let's take a look at who that was. That's going to be Rob Lake, the redshirt sophomore out of Florida. And how about that? The Mercer offensive staff taking a chance there on play action and a wide open wide receiver and a lot of separation there for Rob Lake off the bench.
Well, you know how long that quarterback had the ball in his hands?
About a half a second. And how about that? PC, just when they thought they had momentum for a little bit, 99-yard touchdown reception for Rob Lake to put Mercer up 20 here in the first quarter. See if PC brings some heat here on second and goal from the 8-yard line. Riddle looking over the middle end zone, and the ball by Cannon is going to be caught for a touchdown. Nice diving grab in the back of the end zone. And Tucker Cannon.
Who did you say caught that again?
Tucker Cannon.
Oh, my goodness. They're going to have to smother him.
He's been their go-to guy. And, again, credit that offensive line for giving him enough time and a nice snag with Haygood draped all over him. Good defense, but a better catch.
If you're Tommy Spanger, what do you do? Do you wait? Do you burn a couple of guys trying to get in there and get to Riddle, or do you sit back like that and watch, let him pick you apart in that pocket?
You got to dial up some heat, I think, going into the second half. You just can't give Riddle more than 2 seconds, or else he'll just keep picking you apart. 28-0 lead with 5:25 to go in the third. Here's Riddle off play action. Oh, there's going to be a nice counter play. Yeah. to DeAndre Johnson. Johnson in the open field. Up the near side to the 10. He will not be touched. It is a Mercer Bear touchdown. Wow, 43-yard run to the house as Mercer goes up 34.
Yeah, he let a couple guys lose their shorts on that play.
Yeah, DeAndre Johnson made a couple of guys look foolish on that one. Really nice run. DeAndre Johnson cut it across the field and was not touched.
Right there.
Yep.
You got to break down and be able to make a play and move to either side, and the defenders didn't do that.
So the first down and 10 here for Thompson. Play action, looking down the field, over the middle, right into the defensive back's hands. It's intercepted. This could be a big return for the Bears up the near sideline, and the ball going right back to the Bears into the hands of number 29, I believe it is.
Yes, it is.
We'll take another look at that. Yes, number 29, that is Kendall Bowler, who came up and was right in the middle of that play. Receiver stumbled, and Bowler with the pick and a nice return.
I didn't see the reason to pass the ball there when Pearson was open 10 yards ahead of that.
Now the handoff will go right up the gut, and there's a lot of running room. Off to the races again for the Bears, and it's going to be another touchdown run, I believe it is, from 33 yards out. The Bears off to the races yet again, and this time it is number 21 with the touchdown run. That is going to be Kareem Rogers, the redshirt freshman, who was able to run it into the end zone. Man, the Bears showing their depth at the running back position here to go up 41-0. You see those defensive linemen get stood up there, and then the cut inside down near the goal line. 6:09 left in the ball game here in Clinton. Blue Hose knocking on the door, trying to get on the scoreboard here against the Bear defense. Tyler Huff going to hand it up straight off the gut, and it's a Blue Hose touchdown. Zola Davis as the Blue Hose fan base
well earned
erupts.
Now the ROTC gets to shoot the cannon, but the one thing's for sure is they won't run out of gunpowder today.
No, good for them, though. Good for those young guys to punch one in and get on the scoreboard 42-6. Straight up the gut, center and the guards did their job. Just enough for an opening as Davis ran over the guy on the edge for the touchdown. For the game here for the Mercer Bears. They move to 2-0 here on the season. PC falls to 0-1.